And right now, Oklahoma veterans and federal workers here in the state are feeling the pinch on this third day of the government shutdown. KOCO's Dan Thomas spent the day at Oklahoma City's FAA Training Center. That's where he's live right now. Dan.
Yeah, Ariel, long before this week, they were feeling that pinch from Washington. Take a look at these barrels behind me here. Those are from back a few months ago in the sequester when they had to save a few bucks, so they shut down that entrance. Well, now about half the workforce out here at FAA has been told to stay home.
I'm out of work and been at home for 3 days, or this is my third. It's, you know, it's considering to be painful.
Electronics technician instructor Conley Wicker is one of over 3,000 FAA employees already out of work. He's also the instructor union president, representing people who fix the equipment that keeps the borders safe and planes in the sky.
That jeopardizes the security, well, we feel security or safety of the flying public.
Greg Brooks is the employees union president. He says no one is looking at the pilots' medical certifications, meaning an indefinite delay in new licenses for healthy pilots.
Or unhealthy pilots. Those are the ones I'm concerned with. So if we can identify them and make sure that they're properly tested and maintained.
Wicker says he's worried about the long-term effect on his students and coworkers.
People are going to be coming back just wondering, you know, what's going to happen next. Because we've lost a lot of faith in the folks that we've entrusted to do us right.
And 3,000 out of work could be just the beginning. Ariel, listen to this. If the debt ceiling isn't raised later this month, another 2,000 additional employees here at FAA could be sent home. Reporting live in Oklahoma City, Dan Thomas, KOCO 5 News.
Disturbing reality. Thanks, Dan.